This week, we had an opportunity to meet here in Zimbabwe with the different representatives from universities, from other regions, as far as Portugal, and also other social movements from South Africa, Mozambique, and Zimbabwe. So why we are really gathering today, it's after we discussed this when we met during the World Social Forum in Tunis. We saw the need to come together to go deeper into our discussions, focusing more on the issues which are affecting the communities, the citizens of our countries, especially in our region, Southern Africa, in the SADC region. So the main issues which are focusing more are issues on food, issues on climate change, and also issues on land, as we saw that these are important aspects of life for the citizens. We are aware that a lot of land grabbing is happening in our region, in different parts of Africa and around the world. We also see that there's scarcity of food in our region, and we really want to talk more about the challenges of climate change. What effects has it brought to the livelihoods of the peasants? Now, the main issues which came out from this meeting was that there's need, especially with the landform program which took place in Zimbabwe, we really need to protect it so that all the citizens can also benefit and no more investors will come again and claim the land back. The other issues which also came up was that we are really witnessing that the Mozambicans, they are really into trouble with the pro-savanna and really want to stop that pro-savanna project which is taking place in Mozambique. A lot of mining, a lot of landless people in South Africa, so they also need to come together to see how best we can voice so that the landless people in South Africa can also have their pieces of land to manage their farming systems for their livelihoods. Those are some of the issues which really came up. But then we also see that with the climate crisis, it is not the work of only one person which can really see solving this problem. We have to unite as social movements, because there's quite a lot of work needed to be done, especially lobbying our governments into putting into place policies that really promote the African agricultural way of farming, like agroecology, which we have seen that it is also the farming from the farmers, from the peasants themselves, and it also contains the use of our own indigenous seeds, and also it promotes the use of our own manure from cattle. We can make our own compost from this, so agroecology will be the best, especially to meet the needs of the food sovereignty. We have also managed to differentiate the issue of food sovereignty and food security, whereby food security is just, you just want to see a lot of food which you know who produced the food and how it was produced. So food security, at this moment, in this meeting, we agreed we are not going to talk more about food security, but we really want our African governments to promote agroecology for food sovereignty.